In this video, we'll be going over the basics of working with collections in Blender using Python. And if you stick around, I'll show you some exercises to solidify your knowledge. Hey, I'm Victor Stepanoff. I'll be guiding you through this beginner Blender Python exercise. Today, we're going to be taking a look at collections, and let's jump straight into it. I'm going to navigate to the scripting workspace right here. And to get things quickly started, we're going to use some starter code, some helper code. I've provided a link in the description under start code. So go ahead and open that link in your favorite browser, navigate to raw, select that code and copy it. Now hit new right here and then paste in that code. Before we run it, let's clear the scene by hitting AX and then delete. So make sure to hover over the 3D viewport to do that. And this script right here, just going to add 10 cubes, 10 icospheres, and 10 monkey heads into the scene. So let's go ahead and run that right now. All right. Looks like that ran without any issues. So you should see something like this in your scene. We're going to be working in the interactive Python console. So let's update our workspace layout to make sure that we can see what's going on. I'm going to just move this a bit up here. Then I'm going to add a new window right here, and I'm going to get the outliner. Actually, I'm going to get two of them, one for the scene outline and then another one for the Blender file. You'll see why we need that in just a minute. I'm going to move this out of the way right here because we're not going to be using that for this exercise, and this should be enough for us to start working. You can see that in the scene that we only have one collection that contains all of our objects right here, just called a collection. Let's create a new collection. I'm going to go into the interactive Python console and create a new variable for the collection name. I'm going to call the new collection monkeys. And now we need to run a special command to create a collection through Python. As you can see, I hit tab, and that gives me some documentation about this particular function. It's called BPY data collections and new. And it, as you can guess, it creates new collections. And what we need to do is provide the name. So you can write it like so, providing like a keyword argument so it really makes sense what we're doing here. And just write the variable name for our collection. But before I do that, I'm going to create a new variable. So we're assigning the collection that we're creating to a variable right away. So I'm going to call it collection. And now I'm going to hit enter. And now we have our collection right here. Also, don't worry if you didn't actually get this variable set up beforehand. You can actually do this. So you can still access that collection if you didn't do this assignment right here. You could still access it by looking in the collections and then just entering the name of the collection we just created, like so. This is, you can say that this is a two-step process of first creating the collection and then retrieving it. I just did this in one single swoop by assigning it right away. Okay, let's take a look at where our collection went. Let's look into the scene outliner and let's just scroll down right here. And as you can see, the collection that we created is not here. It's actually in the Blender file, but it's not in the scene. So if we go here in the Blender outline, Blender file outline, and then go under collections, and you can see that right here is that collection that we just added. You probably heard about the concept of linking data, for example, linking materials between objects or linking modifiers from one object to another. We're going to be doing a similar thing. We're going to be linking our collection we just created to the scene collection. So let's do just that down right here, like so, all the way down. Let's go into the interactive Python console. And in the context, scene, and then collection. This is the scene collection that we will be linking our created collection to. So I'm going to create a new variable called scene collection. And I'll need to link our collection that we created to the children of the scene collection. And I'm going to use the collection variable that we created that currently references the collection we created. So watch as I hit enter, our collection is going to appear in the outliner. And look at that, it's right here. So now you can see it's right next to the collection that contains all of our objects. Okay, now let's move the currently selected object into our new collection. So we're going to move this monkey head into the monkey's collection. I'm going to go into the Interact Python console and create a new variable that's going to be referencing this currently active object. So I'm going to be using the context and in particular the currently active object. And as soon as I hit enter right here, I'm going to get a reference to our monkey head. So if I just print our current object, and you can see that it's the monkey head. Okay, now let's use the variable that's referencing to our new collection and link this currently active object to the objects of our collection. So with this command, we're linking the object that we've just selected through Python and linking it to the objects of this collection. Watch how the monkey appears in this collection as I press enter. As you can see that we have our monkey head in our collections, but if you notice, if we open the collection, the original collection, we still have that same object in there as well. This might be a bit confusing, so let's fix that. And we're going to do that by doing the opposite. So to add the object we were linking, and now we need to unlink this current object from the original collection. So as you can see, I'm just trying to access the main collection. And in the similar fashion, I'm accessing the object's properties and then running the unlink function on that. And now, as soon as I hit enter, you'll see that this monkey head is going to disappear out of the original collection, and we're just going to have one reference in our outliner. All right, as expected, it was removed from the original collection. Okay, now let's move the rest of the monkey meshes into this monkey collection. And to do that, we're going to be using a for loop. So we're going to iterate over all the objects in the scene and select only those that are the monkey head meshes, and then move those into our new collection while also unlinking them from the original collection. Let's write that code. To make things more readable, I'm going to create two new variables called source collection and destination collection. This way, it would be clear that we're moving objects from the source collection into the destination collection. We're going to be using the original collection called collection as the source collection. And I'm just going to use the current variable collection, which is referencing our monkey collection, and just create a new variable off of that. It's totally possible for variables to be referencing the same data. I'm just going to be renaming it like so. Now let's loop over all the objects in our scene. So this is a for loop that's going to be looping over all the objects. And now we need to filter only the monkey meshes out of from all the objects that are in the scene. And to do that, we're going to be using the in operator. So it's going to be an if statement with an in operator that's going to be making sure that we're going to be using only monkey heads in our move operations. If this particular syntax is not familiar to you, if you're not familiar with if statements, I have a number of videos for you so you can watch those and make sure to catch up on this part of the exercise. But if you already know if statements, but you're not sure about what this in operator is, I also have a video on that. It's actually the third video on in my if statement tutorial series. So check that out to get quickly oriented with what this in operator does. Now let's unlink the object from the source collection and link it into the destination collection. And I'm pressing, by the way, tab when I open a parentheses to give me an autocomplete, so I don't have to type the whole command. And also it will give you some documentation if there's any documentation available. So I'm gonna hit enter. And before I hit enter again, which will exit out of the for loop in our interactive Python console and make this for loop run. As you can see that this for loop is not running just yet because all of the monkey meshes are still in the original collection. Now let's hit enter and execute this code. And this is fine right here. We're gonna get a error that this Suzanne 009 is not in the collection that's named collection. That's because we moved it just at the beginning of this exercise. It's actually already inside of this collection. We could probably added some more logic to make sure we wouldn't hit this error, but it's okay. We're just gonna let this error go. Now you can see that we've actually moved all of the monkey objects into a collection called monkeys, and they are gone from the original collection just by using that code right there. And now for your first exercise, I want you to create two new collections called cubes and icospheres, and then move all the cubes into the collection called cubes, and then move all the icospheres into the collection called icospheres. Go ahead and try that on your own. Pause the video now, and as soon as you're done, unpause it and I'll show you how I would have done it. All right, let's check out how I would have done this particular exercise. I'm just gonna copy that. And as you can see that the only thing that really changed is this current if statement that we're now looking for cubes. So this particular piece of code is gonna be moving the cubes into the new collection. Make sure that you had the correct way of creating the new collection by creating first the collection and then assigning it into the scene collection, like so right here. And let's execute this code. And now you can see after executing that, we only have icospheres in the original collection, and we have the cubes in the cubes collection. Okay, next is our icospheres. I'm gonna do just that. Just gonna paste in some more code. Exactly, almost identical code, except we're just changing the name of the collection that we're creating. And we're using another string or a text, another piece of text to search for the icospheres in our data. So let's execute that. And now you can see that all the icospheres ended up in the icospheres collection. Great, and you can see nothing is in the original collection now. And if you're learning something new today or just enjoying this exercise, make sure to give this video a like. I'll greatly appreciate it. Okay, for your second exercise, I want you to nest the collections that we created in a new collection called objects. So your outliner is gonna look something like this. Go ahead and pause the video now and try to achieve this. All right, let's check out how I would have done this particular exercise. The main insight here is, you know how we're always linking our new collections into the scene collection? Well, now we need to unlink those collections that we created and link it into a new collection that we will create. I'm gonna quickly copy some code for you just to save some time and then paste like that. And you can see this is what I did. I created a new collection as always, right? Created the collection called objects with the name objects. I linked it to the scene collection as we always do. Next, I created three new variables that are referencing the cube collection, the icosphere collection, and the monkey collection. And then I just linked the cube collection to our new collection and then unlinked it from the scene collection, right? So we got to do two things, link and then unlink. And the same thing goes for the icosphere collection and the monkey head collection. And as you can see, now we have this nicely nested and organized structure of our collection. All right, I hope you enjoyed this exercise. For more videos like this, make sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time.